There we go. Good evening. My name is Philip Keene, and I'm the Director of Jazz Studies here at Snow College. And this is the Jazz One Big Band. And we have a very fun evening for you. Well, I guess it depends on who you ask if it's fun or not. But it's very interesting, we'll say. It's very interesting because the music is very challenging. And it can be very fun if you know how to do it. And so that's why I say it depends on who you ask. If someone perhaps doesn't know their part very well, it might not be very fun. But if they do know it, it will be probably fun. But I'm pretty sure that everybody in here knows their part well. So they should all be having a good time. And I hope that that translates to you. This is one of my favorite composers. This evening's concert is devoted to his music, the great Clare Fischer. And he was somebody who was, I think, not really recognized when he was alive very much, even though he was alongside some of the greatest names like Nelson Riddle and Billy May, and he arranged for Prince for 20 years or something like that. He's a pretty amazing musician, but he was kind of glossed over a little bit. He was also a great pianist as well, but I think these days he's mostly known among musicians as more of a composer, but he was also a great pianist and played on his recordings. So we're gonna treat you to some really interesting music. It's a lot of it goes back and forth between really low energy and really high energy music. And so for that reason, I feel like it brings the audience on a little bit of a ride, and you kind of never know what to expect. With Clare, his music is very, what I call, ear-bending. You listen to it, and for a minute it sounds like something is a little off, and then you listen a little closer, and you realize that that's what he intended. And there were many times in rehearsals when we would be, you know, rehearsing a certain section, and I in particular would be kind of looking at the score and scratching my head a little bit, and we would kind of laugh a little bit about how something was written, and we thought, well, we're not going to argue with the composer. And I think that's one thing that made him great, was that he wasn't afraid to be bold in his music and write things that were made perhaps a little different. But also, his music, I feel, is rooted in the classics and in a lot of, I think a lot of his harmonies come from Thelonious Monk's music. In some of the songs that we're going to play tonight. So it's a good mix of stuff that's kind of pushing the boundaries and also reaching back to tradition. So we're going to start off with a piece entitled Tears, Tears. And before that, we're going to tune, and then we'll get started. Let's hear it. Let's hear it for Nick Moore. And Nate Thomas and Braden Eddington. I'm forgetting people's names. And Ethan Hansen and Brad Sadler. Okay, the next song we're gonna do is a great piece that I was actually introduced to when I was too young to really know how good it was. I think I was maybe 13 or 14 when I first heard this song. And it was completely by accident. It was kind of back in the days of like when they first started like downloading music online, and I remember just like searching around, and I just randomly found this song, and I really liked it. So I'm glad to be able to revisit it again. And this is entitled Gaviota.
Thank you.
Clara Campbell on the vocals, and Nate Thomas on the saxophone. This piece, you'll probably see in the program that all the songs are written by Claire Fisher, but there's, I think, two of them are arranged by Dirk Fisher, who was Claire's brother. And so, pretty musical family, and his son Brent also carries on the torch. And actually, I found out he actually has ghostwritten for some of Claire's music, which is added twist to the whole mystery of Claire Fisher. You wonder what was ghostwritten and what was not. But I think during some of the time when he was working for Prince, that his son Brent was actually ghostwriting some of that. But wouldn't be possible without the all the work that he had done previous to that. So we're going to get on to another song now. This is entitled Pavillon. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's hear it for our soprano Soli right here. This was a lot of work to get together. Eduardo and Nate. It's also hard to play two soprano saxophones and have it sound good at the same time. And they did it very well. So we're going to move on to the quiet side. And I just want to... Never mind. Sorry, I had something in my head that I was going to say and I just forgot what it was. So we're going to go on to the next one, the quiet side.
Thank you.
So I hope you're seeing what I was talking about before, how the harmonies are kind of surprising and kind of catch you off guard a little bit, and it kind of jumps from low energy to high energy, and then back again, and it's you know, really sudden, but also after you listen to it for a while, it kind of makes sense why it's that way. And it's just really, really creative writing. This next piece is actually a jazz standard. Clair was known mostly as a jazz musician, even though he was kind of one of the top arrangers in the mid-20th century and afterwards. But he wrote several of his pieces have become part of the standard jazz repertoire. And this is a piece entitled Pensativa. And I think that it kind of stands out among his other pieces just in terms of how well it's known among the jazz community. So, and this is also a fun key to play in, G flat major. So we're going to treat you to that, and here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have two more pieces for you. And there's a lot that could be said. The first, the one we're going to be playing, is called Canonic Passacaglia. And it features a lot of members of this, of the band in kind of entering the music at different times, often with repeating lines from a previous instrument that was playing before. And it starts out where you can hear everything, and then all of a sudden there's kind of multiple people playing a whole bunch of really complex lines. And then it kind of goes somewhere else later on. It just kind of goes, takes you on a journey. It's a very difficult piece. The last piece we're going to play kind of pays tribute to some earlier styles of music, and that one is entitled "'Twas Only Yesterday." And so here's Canonic Passacaglia. you very much. That was Canonic Passacaglia, and we are going to finish now. Hello? We're going to finish now with "'Twas Only Yesterday," but before we get to that, there's some kind of a hum up here. I don't know if you guys hear it back there, but some kind of a buzz. But first, before we play this last piece, I would like to first acknowledge a few people. First and foremost, Dr. Vance Larson, the chairman of the music program here, without whom none of this would be possible. And our dean of fine arts, communications, and new media, who I believe is sitting right there. Thank you, Dr. Huff, for being here, and his lovely wife. Yeah. I'd also like to thank all of the faculty here, private lesson teachers and the full-time faculty for all the work they do, helping these students to prepare in one way or the other. I'd also like to thank Carla Rauska, who helps us with advertising and social media, and Sherry Nielsen, who I'm pretty sure if she was not here, everything would fall apart. She keeps everything together. So I'd also like to acknowledge Ben Harris and his tech crew, led by Keston back there. I think he's back there, at least, there he is. Okay, the tech crew, obviously making it sound good up here. So, and the students. If we can give a warm round of applause to the students and to everybody that I mentioned. So now we will play "'Twas Only Yesterday," and hopefully you will recognize a few things from the past. Thank you. The Jazz One Big Band. Thank you very much for coming. I hope you have a wonderful night. Thank you.